Hello friends, welcome to all of you in Dr. Jaggi's Academy. In my last video, we have taught about the reaction intermediates such as a free radical and carbon. So with the continuation of previous video, we will study another reaction intermediate such as a carbocation and carbonion. Let's start. So in this video, we will study about the different types of reaction intermediates such as a carbocation and carbonion, and also study their relative stability. So what are the carbocation? Carbocation is a group of atom in which carbon has positive charge. Carbo means carb and cation means positive charge. Those species in which carbon contain positive charge, or we can say that in which carbon has 6 shared electrons. So how does they form? They are formed due to the heterolytic fission of the covalent bond. So to explain it, I am taking the example of methyl halide. In this case, there is a covalent bond between carbon and halogen. So as we know that halide is more electronegative as compared to carbon due to its small size. So it has tendency to withdraw the shared electron toward itself, resulting there is a breakage of covalent bond, and this carbon acquires a positive charge and this halide acquires the negative charge. So in this case, there is a heterolytic fission of the covalent bond. So due to heterolytic fission of the covalent bond, this carbon form a positive charge to form methyl carbonide, and another is halide ion. Next, I am taking the example again, ethyl halide. So again, there is a heterolytic fission of the covalent bond of CX bond. So in this case, due to heterolytic fission of covalent bond, this carbon acquires a positive charge because it loses one of its electron, and this halide acquires a negative charge due to presence of excess electron. So due to heterolytic fission of ethyl halide, we get two products. Number one is that is ethyl carbocation, because carbocation we call as a carbocation because in this case the carbon acquires positive charge. Carbon possess positive charge. So that is why ethyl carbocation. So classification of carbocation. So we have again three types of carbocation depending upon the number, how many number of carbon atom attached to the carbon having a positive charge. So we have first of all that is the primary carbocation. So to explain that, what are the different types of primary carbocation, that is we have a methyl carbocation. In this case, this carbon is primary carbon because it does not attach to any other carbon atom. So positive charge is present on a primary carbon, so that is why it is known as a primary carbocation. Another example is again ethyl carbocation. So this carbon is primary carbon. The positive charge present on primary carbon is primary carbocation. The next example is secondary carbocation. This example of isopropyl carbocation. So in this case, this carbon is attached to two carbon atom. So this is a primary carbon, and positive charge is present on the primary secondary carbon atom is known as secondary carbocation. The next one is tertiary carbocation. So this is an example of tertiary butyl carbocation. So in this case, this carbon is attached to three carbon atom. So this is a tertiary carbon atom, and the positive charge present on a tertiary carbon atom is known as tertiary carbocation. So next is the order of stability of these alkyl carbocation. So we have different type of carbocation, and which one is more stable? So we have a different type of carbocation, such as this one is methyl carbocation, ethyl carbocation, isopropyl carbocation, and tertiary butyl carbocation. So as indicate, this one is tertiary carbocation is more stable as compared to the secondary and primary carbocation. So next, why the tertiary carbocation is more stable than primary and secondary carbocation? So this is explained due to the inductive effect. So as we know, the methyl group is an electron releasing group. So to explain it, I'm taking the example of that is the ethyl carbocation. So in this case, this methyl group is the electron leasing group. So it releases the electron towards this positive charged carbon atom. So due to increase the electron density, the positive charge on this carbon there decreases. As a result, so as the this methyl group they release the electron toward this carbon again becomes some positive charge, acquires some positive charge. It means that is a positive charge get dispersed. First of all, positive charge is present on this carbon atom, but due to an inductive effect, due to electron leasing effect of this carbon atom, small positive charge there also appear on this carbon atom. It means positive charge get dispersed. So the greater the dispersal of positive charge, more is the stability of carbocation. So how does the dispersal of positive charge increases? So greater number of alkyl group attached to the positive charge carbon atom, the greater is the delocalization of positive charge and higher the stability of carbocation. So as we discussed earlier, so in this case, so we have a in this tertiary alkyl carbocation. So in this case, this carbon is attached to three carbon atom. It means this carbon is, this methyl group is electrolyzing effect, it also show electro, and this carbon is also. So in this case, there is a dispersal of positive charge on these three methyl group. Where in the case of the dispersal of positive charge in two methyl group, and in this case the dispersal of positive charge only one methyl group. So in this case, there is a greater dispersal of positive charge. So greater the dispersal of positive charge, higher will be its stability. So that is why tertiary alkyl carbocation is more stable than as compared to secondary and primary. So order of reactivity of the carbocation. So as we know, the reactivity is inversely proportional to stability. So as we know that tertiary carbocation is more stable as compared to secondary and primary. So that is why the reactivity of the carbocation, that tertiary carbocation is less reactive as compared to secondary carbocation, which is also less than that of primary carbocation. The next reaction intermediate is carb anion. So as the name indicates, carb means carbon and anion means negative charge. It means those species that containing a carbon having a negative charge. So these are formed due to a heterolytic fission of the covalent bond containing carbon. So I am taking the example of molecule in which the two carbon, that is C, two atom, that is a one C and B, both are linked by the covalent bond. So due to heterolytic fission, this carbon acquires, that is, a negative charge. The negative charge is present on carbon, so that is why it is known as carb anion. Where the other atom, they are loses a one electron, so that is why it acquires a positive charge. So I am taking the example of, that is, the ethanol. So as we know that carbonyl group is electron withdrawing, so it withdraw the electron toward itself. So this carbon, there is a heterolytic fission due to the electron withdrawing effect. So due to heterolytic fission, this carbon, they has a one more excess electron. So that is why this carbon, due to heterolytic fission of this carbon hydrogen bond, this carbon acquires negative charge. This is known as carb anion. And second one is, that is a hydrogen, because it loses a one electron. So that is why it acquires a positive charge. So we have a classification of carb anion. So as we discussed earlier, so again depending upon the carbon atom attached to carbon having a negative charge. So we have a three types of carb anion. Number one is primary carb anion, secondary carb anion, and tertiary carb anion. So these are the example of primary carbonyl, Next one is secondary carbon ion. This one because the negative charge is present on the secondary carbon. Next one, tertiary carbon ion. This is a tertiary butyl carbon ion because the negative charge is present on a tertiary carbon atom. So the next we will study the order of stability of the different alkyl carbon ion. So these are the different carbon ions. These are the primary carbon ion. This is the secondary carbon ion and this one is tertiary. So as the order indicate, primary carbon ion, they are more stable as compared to secondary and tertiary. Means tertiary carbon ion is least stable. So why? Again, this is explained with the help of inductive fact. So as we know that methyl group is again electron-losing group. So this is a carbon ion. So this methyl group is again electron-losing group. And it releases the electron toward the carbon atom containing negative charge. So due to releasing effect of this methyl group, it increases the electron density on the negative charge carbon atom. So higher the electron density make it unstable. So it is clear that greater number of alkyl group, higher the electron density on this carbon atom containing negative charge and less will be stable. So as it is clear that tertiary carbocation has three methyl group, it means electron density on the negatively charged carbon atom is highest as compared to secondary and tertiary. So that is why that is the tertiary carbo anion is least stable as compared to the secondary and primary. So greater number of alkyl group attached to negative charged carbon atom, greater is the electron density on the negative charged carbon atom and lesser will be stability. So this is again as we know the order of reactivity of this alkyl carbon ion, the reactivity is inversely proportional to the stability. So that is why the order of reactivity, so in this case of tertiary carbon ion is more reactive as compared to secondary and primary carbon ion. So thank you.